The first Shazam movie was actually a decent movie in the DCEU, I would say. Can lightning strike twice?
I get it.
Yeah. Shazam!
Shazam!
Welcome to the Cine Fanatics. My name's Robert Adams.
I'm Chris Adams.
And we got a non-spoiler review for, what was it called?
Shazam 2, Fury of the Gods.
That doesn't seem right.
That's right, my standards.
No, okay. Or as the rest of us call it.
Shazam, Fury of the Gods.
That's weird.
I know, it doesn't roll off the tongue quite as well, does it?
Gods.
Yeah, again, this is a spoiler-free review, so we're not going to spoil anything. I guess that's what that means, right?
You're good to go on this.
Yeah.
Nothing going to be spoiled for you.
Before we get started, make sure you let us know your opinion down below in the comments. Make sure you like this and subscribe, because we're going to be doing some good things here still, like we've done already.
We do a lot of good things here, and you want to see them all.
Yeah. We're not canceled yet, so make sure you follow us.
You say yet.
I know, I need
happen.
To emphasize that yet. Like, it could happen anytime.
It's on
now.
Its way. It's on its way.
It's impending. It's like the storm in Fortnite. It's coming. Or the dome in Shazam. Like,
this is all good stuff to cut out.
Nah, it's fine.
Okay.
Anyways, this was a fun movie. Like, right off the bat, I would say my expectations for this movie, the first movie I feel like was kind of formulaic. The only thing I really liked about the first movie was that interaction between Shazam or Billy and his friend Freddy. Mm-hmm. And then the whole playfulness of him, like, learning that he's a superhero adult. Yeah, that was fun.
The big aspect of it.
Essentially, yeah. Yeah, being able to go buy alcohol or porn or whatever.
Yeah.
Like, that was fun. And then the rest of the movie, it was a superhero movie. It was okay.
He's a superhero with superhero powers doing superhero things, yeah.
So, the nice thing about that, if that was your thoughts, feelings, and opinions of the first movie, your expectations of this one are probably low. Especially because the trailers really didn't show off anything spectacular.
It's also really odd, too, because despite all that, I would still consider the first Shazam one of the better movies in the DCEU.
Ouch.
But it's not a terrible movie. It's just fine.
Yeah.
It's fine. This movie, definitely much better than that first one.
Mm-hmm.
There's so much to enjoy about this one. It's a lot of fun. It's just a good, entertaining 2 hours and 10 minutes.
Yeah.
So it was a lot of fun just to sit there and watch it. There's some good humor. There's all sorts of good stuff about this movie.
Yeah. So real quick, let's deep dive a little bit into this. Let's get into some good stuff. First of all, kind of like what we were saying, this movie's fun.
Yeah.
Like, again, the stuff I was pointing out about the first movie, that was fun for just the small portion of that movie. This movie was fun, like, pretty much the entire time.
It's fun in that you had all the, like, the goofy nature of just the idea of who Shazam is, kid to adult superhero. But on top of that, you get the lore of Shazam in this movie, too. They kind of dive more into who is Shazam, where do the powers come from, what does it all mean? I mean, the movie's called Fury of the Gods, so you understand that there's a god aspect that they're diving into in this movie. And they do have a lot of fun with that side of things, kind of doing the deep diving and kind of figuring out what all everything means. Where do these powers, what is this, what is Shazam, you know, all that kind of stuff.
Yeah, so I enjoyed it based off of that alone. I think, like, for the most part, there were some, like, little bit of lulls here and there, but it was fun the whole way through. That being said, the reason why I think so is the movie was silly without being stupid. There's a lot of times when you get into this kind of movie, especially when it's something like kids playing a fish out of water type of role, sort of like this.
Yeah.
There's a lot of times where, like, the writers, who are very likely adults, are going overboard on some of those jokes, and what happens is it causes the audience to roll their eyes, like, okay, that was...
Let me make the adults say funny kid lingo.
Yeah.
What's the popular thing the kids are saying nowadays? Hello, fellow kids.
Yeah, like no cap or whatever. I'll be bussing with no cap.
Bussing, yeah, all that kind of stuff. See how cringe it is? See how cringe it is when I don't say it?
I cringe it when I say it, and that's why I don't say it.
We're both over 30 here. Let's be honest about this.
So we're 40. Anyways.
You know, I wasn't going to say it.
Thank you. You're so respectful of your older brother. It really didn't feel like it was that stupid. There wasn't like very many, in my opinion... very much like groan or cringe humor.
No, it was all the humor was pretty on point.
Yeah.
On top of that, the characters in the movie, you had the great family dynamic that we had before, but raised up because this time we actually got a good amount of screen time for everybody. The kids as kids, the kids as adults, superheroes, all of it. Everyone had their moment to shine in the movie, which you only got that kind of like that back and forth dynamic at the end of the first one. It's spread out evenly throughout this entire movie.
Yeah, I think the script for this movie did a good job of balancing out all the actors.
Mm-hmm.
I love, like, there was a lot more that the foster parents in this movie were incorporated, that they were involved in, and I love their characters even more. They were fun characters in the first one.
Yeah.
I really love them in this one.
Yeah.
Granted, they don't do too much, but I feel like they're a lot more focused in this movie. They have a lot more to do with this movie, and I love them a lot more.
Yeah. I do like the balance dynamic. Like, obviously, you know, you've got the kids as superheroes. We get a good amount of time of them working together as a team, which you only get that at the end of the first one.
Yeah.
But it's like hitting the ground running in this movie. You know that there's a team. There's a dynamic to them as a team. Each one of them wants to kind of like have their own personality and who they are as a hero. You kind of get all of this stuff sprinkled in. And I think it's a really fun way to take that. Whole thing.
And I like that you get like the kids also showing that aspect. Yeah. Like when they're not superheroes and they're just the kids basically acting like these superheroes as well, for better or worse,
yeah.
I should say. But yeah, I feel like that all worked out very well. Not spoilery, the movie begins with the scene on the bridge that we've seen in the trailer. And while it was fun, I did think, I was like, great, superheroes on a bridge. Like, they haven't done this in Fantastic Four and two Spider-Mans, all right? So
some X-Men movies sprinkled in there.
Yeah, I mean, everyone's got to be on a bridge. But, like, it was fun. It was probably one of the better superheroes on a bridge action scenes that I've seen. So,
yeah, it was a lot of fun. On top of that, the movie itself, like I said earlier, clocking at 130 minutes, about 2 hours, 10 minutes, paced very well. Doesn't feel too long, doesn't feel too short, feels right at the right amount of time. You know, you go into this wanting something to kind of like, it's a superhero action movie, so you want it to hit at you fast, hit at you hard, have a lot of good time, and it does that. It keeps that pace pretty well throughout.
Yeah, I didn't feel like it was really, like, going dull or anything. Kind of like what I tend to do when I ramble on about what movies I love and stuff. So,
right.
Yeah. And then, like, looking at the individual people, I mean, there's so many people involved in this movie. But I think one of the standouts in this was easily Rachel Zegler.
Yeah.
What her character, and, like, there's a reason why we didn't see so much of her character in the trailer. And I know we talked about this on trailer reactions. Like, they're intentionally holding something back. They are. And I like what they do with it. Like, it works very well, and I'm pleasantly, like, I wouldn't say surprised, but I like how it was written.
She's a star. She's doing great things in this movie, and we're going to continue to see her star power rise because she's just really good.
Yeah. Let's get to the bad part of this. Like, I mean, granted, yes, as much as we're hyping up the praise,
there's some things. There's some things.
Me personally, I'm not a huge fan of the Shazam character played by Zachary Levi compared to what's essentially the same exact human being of Billy Batson played by Asher Angel.
Yeah.
And I feel like it's really weird, but I feel like Asher Angel was playing that character as more of an adult than Zachary Levi was playing it. Zachary Levi was more goofy and silly and kid-like, while all the scenes of Asher Angel, he's more adult and focused and trying to be responsible, and it was really weird.
It's weird. It's definitely something that I feel like was present in the first movie as well. I feel like the dynamic between the two is just not quite on point, wherein, Zachary Levi feels like he's playing a kid as an adult, but when it flips back to Asher Angel as the kid, he doesn't feel like the same kid. He doesn't feel like the same goofy personality, like, I'm a superhero, this is crazy, whoa. He feels very, like, refined and like, you know, this is my life. I'm in the foster care system, this, that, and the other. He feels very, like, stoic as a child, wherein Shazam, Zachary Levi, feels a lot more childlike. Mm-hmm. Which is, it kind of throws off the dynamic a little bit. It doesn't completely take me out of the movie, but it's still something that it's noticeable. And that's a problem I had with the first one. It hasn't gone away in the second one.
Yeah. That was kind of eating at me a little. The other thing with this movie, and this unfortunately is something that happens with a lot of superhero movies, the villains are pretty one note.
Which is unfortunate considering you have Helen Mirren and Lucy Liu.
Yeah, I mean, great actresses.
Yeah.
Them, the actresses as people acting, mm-hmm, works very well.
the folks who come in and they do the job of the portrayal of the character,
they're very good at what they do, and I absolutely love them as actresses.
It's a situation where they're given the script and they do the most with what they're given, but what they're given is very one note, one dimensional. It's very thin. There's we're gonna say imposing villain like things, and we're gonna stand here and be imposing villain like characters, but it just doesn't feel like there's more depth beyond we just have the one simple motivation.
And I know it's like a very harsh comparison given what people think of this movie as well, but mm-hmm, I kind of compare them to Christopher Eccleston in Thor the Dark World.
Kinda, yeah.
As Malekith. It's a very one note, like, hey, I'm a supervillain, I just want to conquer the world, and like, what are you gonna do with the world when you conquer it? It's my favorite joke.
They give us reason for us to feel like they're villains at the beginning of the movie, but outside of that, it's like, why do I care about, what are the stakes, why do I care about what you're doing?
Mm-hmm.
Why does that matter?
So you're mentioning the beginning of the movie. There's like the part of them at the beginning, they're flexing massive amounts of power, and then that power is essentially gone for the rest of the movie.
We don't see it activated throughout the rest of the movie.
If they had done what they did at the beginning of this movie, they would have been incredibly dangerous threats.
Yeah.
But they don't do that.
Yeah.
There is like something, like a small dynamic about them that happens later in the movie that I do like, and I feel like it does throw like a small like little twist, mm-hmm, on their relation,
yeah,
the relationship and how they act and behave. I liked what they did with that, but other than that one little thing, the rest of it,
yeah. And again, right, just to reiterate, that's how the characters were written. It's kind of, I think, an issue with how the characters were written, yeah, not so much with how they're portrayed, because again, you got Lucy Liu and Helen Mirren in your superhero movie, and first of all, tickets sold, but secondly, it's Lucy Liu and Helen Mirren. They've been around the block a few times. We know how good they are, and they did the best that they could with what they were given.
You should be thanking the gods that you got those two to star in your movie.
It's true.
So, I mean, obviously, I believe they were having a lot of fun on set. They both look like two people that would have a blast doing a movie like this. So, kudos to them for enjoying and having a good time while doing their job and their passion. But, yeah, script, a little lacking on that. Mm-hmm. The only other negative thing I would say, I need to go back and see this myself because I'm not completely familiar, but apparently there are complaints that the trailers for this movie may have shown a little bit too much.
Which means if you have not seen more of the more recent trailers lately,
don't watch them.
Don't watch them. If you haven't seen them, don't watch them. If you have seen them, yeah. It was fun.
Write a stern letter to Warner Brothers.
It was fun, and I didn't know what the trailer was doing. I didn't know what they were showing. I had a lot of fun not knowing that before going into the movie.
Yeah,
I'm so sorry if you saw it before.
Because I don't think we did a reaction to that last one, so we were good.
Yeah, so there you go. If you're spoiled, sorry.
But again, tweet at WB.
Yeah.
So
tell them, what the hell, man?
Yeah, there are essentially like two post credits. There's a mid credits and a post credits, which was funny because the theater we were in, like, most everyone stuck around for the mid credits, mm-hmm, but then like 3/4 of the theater emptied out, and I actually audibly made the comments like, "Have y'all never been to a comic book movie before? Like, what the hell?" So
yeah. That being said, we know it's all up in the air right now as to whether a Shazam 3 happens or not. at this point, given the direction that this movie went and how much fun I had with this movie, I know you had fun with it too. I wouldn't mind seeing a Shazam 3. I don't know how it works in conjunction with everything else that James Gunn's doing with the new DCU as it's coming down the line. But if they can make it work, cool. I would love to see a Shazam 3 at this point. I think it's a ton of fun.
Yeah. Anyways, that's going to do it for this review. We really like this movie.
Ratings?
Yeah, I'm going to rate it. I'd say like based out of 10. I'm trying to remember what I rated the last one. I mean, I had fun with this movie. I would probably give this movie like a 7.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I'm saying about a 7, 7.5. If that's not higher than whatever I originally rated the first Shazam movie, then just knock the first Shazam movie underneath this one.
I will be adjusting my letterbox score later.
I'll have to go back and look at it. And the first Shazam movie will be adjusted in accordance to this one. Some people might think that's like recency bias, but truly, I've seen the first movie. I've seen this movie. I like this movie more.
Yeah, I mean, so. I just watched the first movie again the other night in preparation for this. So, I mean, I've seen it recently also. So
solid 7.5. I mean, look, again, when we say a 7.5 for a DCEU movie, we're talking about the upper echelon of DCEU at this point. So,
yeah.
Not to be a hater, but...
Yeah. So, again, what did you think of this movie? Let us know down below in the comments. Did you like this review? Drop us a like and subscribe. We're doing fun things, like we said at the beginning of this.
Fun things.
Come follow. Anyways, what else we got to do? Plug things. Let's plug some things. We got our live show, The Tagline, every Wednesday night. We're talking about movie news. We do rankings generally once a month on The Marquee, so come stop by for those. Those are a lot of fun to do. Mm-hmm. We got the Cine Fanatics podcast, where we'll sit there and talk about something for like, I don't know, about an hour,
something
roughly.
Something movie-related.
Movie-related.
We're going to talk about Chia Pets on this next one.
I hope not. God, good Lord, I have nothing to add to that.
Cha-cha-cha-chia.
Anyways, so that's almost everywhere you can get your audio podcast video version right here on this channel. You can follow me personally at Robert Adams MLP on Twitter, Instagram, and Letterboxd. Also, youtube.com/@RobertAdamsMLP.
And you can follow me at Chris Adams MLP on Twitter, Instagram, and Letterboxd, as well as twitch.tv/ChrisAdamsMLP.
Yeah, make sure you follow us together on the Twitter and Instagrams at CineFanaticsMLP. Anyways, again, that's going to do it for this review. Thank you for watching. We will see you later. Y'all all have a good night. Shazam!
Shazam!
Copycat.
Furry of the Goads.